In this episode, we venture to Guysborough County here in Nova Scotia, to a small area called Melrose by the St. Mary's River. Now, in this area is a historic gold mining zone called Cochrane Hill, and at the west end of this zone is an old gold mine called Crow's Nest. Now, the old Crow's Nest gold mine area is way back in the wilderness. There is some old logging roads that head up there, but there's lots and lots of gems to find. Very, very unexplored, very untouched by human exploration at this point. We ended up being very surprised with what we found there, and it ended up being so extensive with things to see that we're going to break this into a two-part episode. So there will be this episode and the next one covering all the stuff that we found in the Crow's Nest Zone. Now, just before we get started on heading into the footage of the episode, I need to get out of the way a definition for you, and that is an open cut. Now, we've not been able to show any of you an open cut on any of the previous episodes all the way back to the beginning of this channel because, frankly, we've not come across any good specimens of any in all of the mine hunting that we've done thus far. But the Crow's Nest gold mine blew us away. It had several major and hazardous examples of abandoned open cuts. You need to know what they are before we start showing them to you here. Basically, an open cut is almost like a vertical open stoping method of mining where they start with a vein they discover in a mountain or a hill or just the earth in general, and they basically take it out from the surface by cutting it and going down, 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 creating a large wound or chasm that just goes down 10 stories deep or more until they reach the bottom of it and remove it. What this leaves behind in the mountain is a large chasm that goes down like a canyon, very, very narrow but extremely deep, with vertical sides and very, very hazardous to come across when you're mine hunting. So now that you understand what an open cut is, let's get going. Now for the footage of the Crow's Nest Gold Mine, Part 1. All right, here we are today in Crow's Nest in Guysborough County. We're back in the woods here mine hunting because there's quite a lot of interesting spots that we wanted to see. And the reason for that is Department of Natural Resources has several horrifying mine openings marked that are left untouched back here in the forest, all rated high hazard and nil escape. This first one is an open cut. And I've left the iris open here so you can see down into it. This chasm goes down, oh my goodness, probably a good 80 to 100 feet, and it heads off down there into the left, into that darkness you see. Let me just open up the iris a bit more. But yeah, we're gonna go point to point here today. We're gonna show you these, and there's some adits here as well, so stick around. So he's down in there trying to get some pictures from a different vantage point of that opening at the bottom of that open cut. We don't know how far back that that opening goes, but we might have to come back some other day, some other year, and do rope work down into there. Meanwhile, behind him, the trench does continue here over to another ridiculous open cut that might even be deeper. I'll try my best to get a shot of it here. There it is there. I'll open up the iris some more. That one's even deeper, probably touching, I'd say we're in the 125 foot plus depth range. And like I say, the coming up here to the forest floor, it's just sheer straight sided edges going down into there. So this is why, folks, Department of Natural Resources rates these as high hazard, nil escape. One moment you're walking and the next moment you're falling 12 stories to your death, and there is no escape once you're down there. It's sheer vertical sides. So I've made my way all the way to the end. This trench goes for probably 400 or 500 feet, and it just, like I say, is down 100 foot plus the whole way, this open cut. And it's really hard to try and film, but here I am standing on a ledge, and very precarious situation here. Like I say, in front of me here, beyond those branches, it goes down a good 80 to 100 feet. And again, it goes higher and lower depending how far along the open cut you go. The very tail end where we went around, see that blackness down there in the center of the screen? That down there is another great big opening way down at the bottom, like a cave. It probably goes into some workings. Again, just bottomless, can't really see. We've got flashlights and Sean down there, but again, down there you're looking at 125 to 150 feet plus. Okay, here we are at the ledge again. Further down, a great vantage point, all the white moss here. Try and give you a peek over the edge to let you see what we're talking about here. There's looking over to the other side of the open cut, and then looking down where we are, we'll open up the iris. As you can see here, a sheer straight face. Yeah. There's opening up the iris. There's what the bottom looks like. And it does go in under there like a cave. So there's looking up to the right. There's looking up to the left. And again, the open cut continues in both directions, but this is one of the deep spots. All right, here we are back at the original end of the open cut. Like I say, this is 400 or 500 feet long and about 100+ feet deep. As we look down, this again was the original part that looked like a cave. I'll open up the iris for you there so you can get the best look I can give you. Just goes down into pitch darkness. The camera actually sees more detail than I can down there. We've talked amongst ourselves, and I think we're going to come back here for maybe a future episode and rope this whole thing, take some walks down in these dark trenches. So, potential sequel for next season. But today, there is no getting into these, that's for sure. We followed onward further coordinates, and we've discovered that there is another open cut here. Let me close down the iris again. The light here is very intense. But we found something down here. This one's more where we can climb from the forest floor down into it. A little shallower, a little less dangerous. And this one comes down into what looks like a tunnel. Again, there's the forest floor up there. This open cut goes into a tunnel as well, except this time we can kind of get down into it. Nice and mossy. He says he's at the end. So he's there at the end. So they took out what they wanted. That's what they were following in these open cuts. Wow. Oh yeah, you can see.
Down in my holes.
Yep.
One there.
And that's the vein.
Yeah.
Very distinct. Just like a ribbon going right up the ceiling. Yeah, that's probably 2 to 3 feet wide, depending on where you look. All right, here's looking out of it, back to civilization. Let's go on to the next point. We're following the open cut still, coming across more, as they're all seemingly in a row, but separated by hundreds of feet now. And here's a vantage point of looking down the cut that we're following. And what did you say you found down there? Okay, he's found a tunnel down there. And wasn't there something about a shaft? Or is that it?
Yeah, no, there's two shafts inside of it.
Really?
Yeah, and they go down to beyond you can't see.
All right, let's get down there and have a look, folks. All right, here we are down at that open cut end that he found. And can you shine your beam down in there? Yeah, it goes down a ways. There's a tree growing out of it here. But there is some kind of a, oh yeah, there's an opening down there to the right. All right, I've scrabbled down in here a bit, and There's a bit of danger down there. There's a ledge right there in the middle of the screen that drops off into a slope that we can't see the bottom. So he's warning to stay away from scrabbling all the way down there to the bottom, because if I fall into that black hole to the right, we're done. But he's come in from the other end. This open cut goes underground here into a stope. As you can see, it goes up into the ceiling there. So they took the vein out sort of on a slight angle. And we're gonna eventually go around there. He says there's a good vantage point to look down that hole. He's gonna throw a rock down. Jesus, mother of God.
Would you want to fall down there?
Do you hear how far that and long that went?
Yeah, that's what I said. Don't come any closer to the edge.
Okay. I'm backing up out of here. We're going to come in the open end that he came in over at the other end. And we'll take a peek down there. Wow. All right, on the way to the end where we're going to meet up with him to come in from the other side, there is an interesting cut here in the middle of the forest floor that you must watch out for. This stuff, folks, is hazardous, and as much as DNR says they mark it, I don't see any signs, but it's actually a skylight down into the where we're going, where they stoped right up to the surface, so it's an open stope. There they are down there. Beautiful. All right, here we are down here at the end. If we push through these trees, here's the end of the open cut, that underground open stoping. Amazing. Okay, opening it up a bit more, so you can see more light. Here's the moss taking a grip where it gets some small amount of sun from the opening. Here's the opening to the forest. And coming in to this open cut, which is mostly underground, there's the far pinpoint of light up in the distance there in the center of the screen where we were before, yep. And then there's the skylight that I was just at, where they stoped right up to the surface. So we're heading down here to this drop-off of death. Wow, my mother of God. All right, so looking into there, I'll do my best to get shots. Yeah, with some rope work, you know, there's a drift there that goes straight. Again, they're probably following the vein or the ore body they were after. It's just underneath this level. The ungodly part is the distance down. I don't even want to lean out there to look down. So again, Crow's Nest is going to need some rope work for a full true explorer. Sequel, anyone? All right, let's get out of here and move on to the next point. Okay, still while moving to other coordinates that we had, we're finding stuff that is not marked and not on the DNR coordinates, just in the middle of the trees. You come across more crazy shit. Just like here, this is another open cut, a stope to the surface, where they went down. I'll shine the light down there. You can see, took out a narrow band. That goes down a good 50, 60 feet. Again, just sheer face. If you fell down in there, there's no escape. Okay, we've made it to the first flag of a shaft on our GPS, first shaft point here in Crow's Nest, and this one is faithfully marked, so that's a change. I haven't seen these signs in a while. But over here, if you come to this god-awful edge, there is a sheer drop. I'm going to use this tree to hold on to, and I'll open up the iris as far as I can get it. And this is what we're dealing with down there. We've thrown rocks down there. There might be a bottom there, but it shoots out. Yeah. See, so there you go. 3 to 5 seconds. We'll have to time that on the screen once we edit, because that's quite a rock roll. But that's how far down that goes. There it is, our first shaft. There's actually another one we're gonna go to. Let's go check that out. All right, we've come across that second shaft. We're stopped here. Just comes across you like a surprise. You don't expect to find this. It looks like an adit at first, but of course there's the back wall and it just goes straight down. So again, there's a DNR sign. Gotta be very, very, very careful in here, because this is a sheer edge drop. It goes down into a, just look at the screen. It goes down into a bunch of stalls, and there is a bottom there. So that's the second shaft. And we have an adit next, which is just nearby this, maybe 100 feet away. So let's go hunting for that. All right, we've come down from the shafts, and we're down here at brook level. And we have found the adit. And the boys are down here. Let's have a look. Oh, beautiful cool breeze coming out of there. You open up the iris here. Right, these weren't meant to be too long, folks. From what we knew, they were anywhere from 40 to 60 meters long. So let's just see where these go. It's quite a lot of airflow coming out of here, though.
Yeah.
So maybe that does connect to those shafts we saw earlier. Let's go find out. In we go. There's some water, but we will try to navigate. We think that this has a relationship with those shafts that we were just at previously. So I can tell you there's quite a breeze coming out of here. So I'm assuming that we are connected to one of those, but we won't know till we get down there. So we're gonna wade in the water, wade in the water. The water is getting shallower as we go. Here's looking back at the mouth where we came from. Okay, I'm coming up on our first soldier. He says he's in a gigantic stope. Gigantic by what measure? Oh. Gigantic in the way that we're not even going to get across there, are we? Oh. This kind of gigantic. Wow. Oh, we're in there's a stope here that's probably 100 feet from floor to ceiling and 100 feet wide. Can you shine your light up in there? And the drift does continue, but it's across this leap of faith. I mean, I guess it's possible if we step over onto this and climb up. Don't know. All right, I'm over on the other side. This is the tunnel in the distance. It's fucking freezing in here and I'm shaking, but there's the, what we think is the end. I'm not gonna hop up on this ledge because I'm on really bad footing down here. Show my feet. And I don't wanna fall down into the abyss standing on a rotted log. So this tunnel will have to stand as is. That does look like definitely a wall there, about 100 feet, so. Okay, the view from over on the other side. Here's me on me boots on a precarious piece of rotting wood on a 45 degree angle. There's that rope coming down from the landing. There's the guys in the adit coming out on the other side. Here's, of course, the tunnel continuation, the adit on the other side where we just peeked. But this is a great vantage point. This amazing, massive, stope and stalls of this chamber taken out of here. Here's up in the other direction. There's all the stalls that go up in there into the, that's the shaft that goes up to the surface. There's a little pinhole of daylight up there you can see. Let's go. Look at that quartz dough. Look at that quartz. Shale, shale, quartz. I'm not actually sure that's shale. But that's fucking quartz. We have a helmet crash. That's why we wear them.